Well, hello, and thank you for joining me. And today I'm going to do an episode of a crafting video. I made these flowers right here and that one there. And my daughter Sue dressed this angel doll, which has got a cute little bow and a little dress. And she tied it in the back when she was here. And she also made me this cute little bow. And this cute little bow. I wish she was here to continue making me some things. But last night I did 60 or more coffee dyed papers. And no, that did not stop. Because then I needed to put two covers on my manila folders. So let me show you what I did. I put this folder on. I mean, that cover. And that cover of this little girl with the rose. This one here was done. Not done, it just had the cover. And then after I did the coffee dyed papers, I put them all in all five of these books. And that didn't take me very long because I'm getting better at doing my signatures. So they're not finished by no means, but I want to show you how they look. And I'm trying to do this with one hand, so I'm gonna go into this one here. This has some lace attached and two different lace for the binding. The flower that I just made, this is the back where I stained it and Mod Podged it, glued the lace to the cover. Then in here, I haven't worked on in here, but I'm going to keep this open because it's good to tuck papers in with the journal. I put some lace on about five or six of the pages. I didn't want to do them all, but this one, I don't think that I've embellished at all. But I'm going to show you my signature. It's sewn in. I've left a few strings in case I decide to attach something or just tie it in a bow. But I've got some lined paper, some coffee dyed paper, and this one I don't think has any envelopes. This is my second signature going into it. But most of them I put two pieces of coffee dyed paper, a lined paper, an envelope. And then I went back to doing the coffee dyed paper, the lined paper, and the envelope until there's my second signature middle. So I still have to yet embellish this, but I just want to show you how they're coming out. And that is the back. So then this one here, I put this lace that I found at the Dollar Tree. This lace I got from a thrift store haul. $2 for a whole bag of this beautiful different types of lace. So this one is on a manila folder. This was already pre-done. And then I put the coffee dyed papers in and attached the lace this morning. If I can get it undone. Trying to do this with one hand, so bear with me. It's coming, but it's slow in the process. Okay, here we go. I think I'm getting closer. Okay, we're in. So this one has a pocket. I just threw in a little baggie because I didn't know what to do with it. This here is from Trisami Rose. This here is just some cardstock. I put lace and some of the papers got the lines because I put them on a baker's rack. I saw that in Paul and Lemon's video. And then I got my envies in here. So you can do a tuck spot, and some you can I leave open. But let me just get my bearings together here so I can show you how to move. But I put in some graph paper. I did this as a tuck spot and put lace on it. The envelope. So I haven't embellished them all, this one here. I just got some tags. I haven't put no cardstock on them, but I'm putting the leftover lace on my pockets. And I got this from Pat on YouTube. And this is Josami Rose picture that's coming up. Second signature. I'm just going a little fast because I have to switch hands. So then in here, I put in a piece of bold paper that cut out with the stamps that I have and just made it into an old piece of paper. Put another pocket here with some lace. This is the middle of the second signature. They're coming out really nice, considering it didn't take me very long to put the papers in after I coffee dyed them. And this morning I did the lace. I did my pocket like that. At an angle, and this is Josami Rose and probably another tuck spot, and that's the front and this is the back. So that's that one. Let me just get rearranged here. I'm gonna put you down on my knee because it's easier if I can hold this Samsung. So this one here, I did the white lace and I put this pink because I did some it's a tacky glue. I'm trying to think of what it is. It probably come to me, but I did her hat and this bird. So let's go into this one. They're all not embellished. They were just started yesterday. So, just going to show you that I'm working on 5, that's all. This one here has the cardstock. And I have lace on 5 or 6 of the pages. This was an image on Pinterest. Josami Rose. Then see, I left some of my envelopes open so you can slide as a tuck spot. And I also have the ends open. Sorry, I'm trying to do this with one hand. Let me see if I can hold it with my foot. This here is a belly band with a piece of lace. And I got a little tag. In this one, there's my signature, middle. You can probably hear my chickens. They're out. My husband let them out for the day so they can forage. We're getting a dozen of eggs a day. I know this has nothing to do with this video. I like the graphic paper in here. I had like 5 sheets left in my book and I wanted to tear it out and get rid of it. So that looks really neat. So thank you, Paula Lemon, if you're watching this video. I love putting them on the rack. See how nice it looks with the lace on the side? It looks really pretty. I'm going kind of quick because I want to get this video done. So it's all basically the same. It's not, that's the second signature sewn in. And I got a couple of tags in this pocket. And I learned this from Pat. And I'm a Josami Rose tags. It was a free download. And that was a Pinterest page. And I love how it came out. My ink was running out, but I decided to keep it in because I like it. So that's the back. And let me turn this one over. And that's the front and back of that. So I have 2 more to share with you. This one here is kind of hard type of material. This was a cardstock that I bought at Hobby Lobby. This lace is from Dollar Tree, and that's the back, and that's the front. And I just put the lace on this morning. See, this is a little harder because I put some paper from a book, and I put tape down, this crafting tape that's really thick, and that image is from Pinterest. Then I made this, but I haven't finished it yet. I got two little tags in there, and they are from Trisami Rose. They have to still be inked. And I love this, the jelly bean and putting the paper across with the lace on it. I think that looks so Victorian. So I might do that to a lot more of my papers. There's my enclosure. And that's from Trisami Rose. I got lace on like 5 or 6 of my pages. I didn't want to use up all my lace, but I wanted it to look feminine, and that's from Trisami Rose. And that's the putting in the second signature. And a lot of my envelopes are open right here. Let me show you. So you can use that as a tuck spot, and I might seal it up and you can slide something in right here. Hope you can see that. My hand's in the way. I'm sorry. Trisami Rose. And I put lace on this one. That's the middle of the second signature. I think that this is part of my best work. It didn't take me that long to do the signatures because I'm getting better. And when I dyed the paper, I was just going to stop with dyeing the paper. And then I decided to sew the signatures in. Then I said to my husband, I got 5 done. So I took a break and I took a little nap. And then I embellished a little bit. And I knew I had to get up at 4:30 to do my pickup this morning for coupons. So then I could have went back to bed, and I wanted to do the lace. So this one here, I turned the lace up. I wanted some red in it because she's got red in the flower. This here came with a gift, so I used it on this one because I didn't have any red. And that's the front, and that's the back. These ones here, I used my punch. I left this open here so you can slide papers in. I like that idea. I'm just different. I left this open so you can slide things in. So this has not been embellished at all. That's the first signature. That's the closure. And I'm just showing you because these have not been all embellished. But I just wanted to get them started. There's a second signature. There's some lace on some of the edges. And I haven't decided what I'm going to do for the inside of this one. But that's the front and the back. And thank you for joining me. I hope you like all of my crafts. I especially love these little bows that my daughter made. This one is just so cute. Be nice to have some of them in my journals. And I love how this flower came out. So I put it right on her because she's got a beautiful hat. And that I thought that these were a little bit puffy and this was a little bit too flat. I could be wrong. And I see how thick it is. So I'm still going to use them, but I just decided that I like this one better because it's more vintage and it matches this journal. So thank you for joining me and have a great and blessed day, and talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.